In this tutorial, we're going to look at how to create an artwork with Polygon.js and set up our scene so that we can then upload it to FxHash and have our artwork available to the community. So we're going to start with this pre-created scene, which I have already set up, which contains light, cameras, and some geometries being processed. And when we move our cursor over it, the text reacts in this semi-organic way. So that what we need to do now is FxHash requires us to have this snippet in the exported HTML, and that snippet gives the fxrun function, which is what will give the seed to the artwork, so that the artwork can vary on every reload or on every variation. So we want to have that snippet somehow in the editor so that we can try and link the function to any parameter that would be available in our scene. And the way to do that is to edit the editor config file. The editor config file allows you to add any script. And that is the default as you create your project. And if I was to uncomment this, for instance, and I can replace that by an alert. And now if I simply reload the page, you can see that this alert is actually being displayed, so that this script is being executed. So I'm going to replace that by the snippet here. So I'm taking everything except the script HTML tag, like this, and I'm going to give the ID, like this. And now if I reload the scene, not a lot happens, but I can always open the developer console and I can here type fxrun, and I can see that every time I call the function I get a different result, which is what it should do. So the function is now available in the editor. Now the question is, how do we link that to a parameter? So let's say I'm going to create a text node and I'm going to display that. I will make that flat and centered for now. And I'm just going to transform it so that we can see it better. So now let's say I want the result of fxrun here. So I can use quotes to put an expression. So I could put 1 plus 1 like that, and you would evaluate this expression. And I can also load a JavaScript function. So in that case, I can say fxrun here. And now I will get the output of that function. So that's one way to use that in any parameters. So now what I don't want in that particular setup, I don't want to use this fxrun directly. I want to use the features or variations, which is explained slightly below in the documentation, which are here. And so for that, we're going to define another script. And we are going to simply copy paste that for now. And we are going to change the content of that. And let's call this fxhash features. And if we simply copy this for now, and let's see what we have as we reload. I don't need to save my scene for the moment. So if we type $, I think it is fxhash features. Super. So that's the actual feature that we have now. Let's try and have it so that we affect the material that is displayed on the text. And so let's have the input of that switch affected by a feature. So let's say I want to have in one case return a 0, another case return a 1, and the last case return a 2. And I can remove that. Let's call that material. And let's rename that getMaterial. Now if we reload our page, I'm going to save now. And if I reload the page get 0 this time. If I reload the page, I get 2 this time. So it will change every single time. And now let's put this in the same way in our parameter. So I just put the JS to evaluate the JavaScript, and then I can copy this. I get an error temporarily, but here we go. Now we have this material. If I save my scene and I reload, it will be a different material. So that's, now we have the variation that FxHash requires that are affecting the behavior of our scene. And the last thing that we need to do is to define how we are going to export that. So if we go into the save options, here we need to define create, make sure the create is actually, the export is actually being created. We want the compressed JavaScript file to not be exported, because that will only increase the size of our zip file, because we currently we still want the non-compressed JavaScript file, and we want to create a zip file so that we have the export done easily. And you can leave this one off or on, it does not really matter. We save those options and we save our scene again to make sure it saves with the correct options. And you can check that your scene is correctly exported. This is the file that we have. And now if we look at the zip file, the zip file will be here. This is the file that we need to give to FxHash. So if we try to upload it, we are going to see this one feature, and as we try the new variations, we're going to see the material is going to be updated. So that is the main thing for this tutorial. And I realized I forgot to put those this actor node on, so I'm going to re-upload. So this is important so that when we play, we have the behavior over the text. Now I'm going to re-upload, and let's go back to that page. Min generative, do it again, next step, and we can simply go back in here and the zip file has been regenerated. We upload and now we can see that the text is behaving as it was initially, and we can keep retrying new hashes. We're going to see a different material every time.